Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the HSBC BWF World Tour Finals. Let's make history together. It's time for battle. Semifinals.
Women's double semi-final. Please welcome Lee So-hee and Shin Chung-chan from Korea. Welcome, Chow Mei Guan and Lee Meng Yan from Malaysia. From Thailand. Service judge, Wahyana from Indonesia.
I have red and black. Which is? Black? The red. Black? Service? Who service? You see? Who is it? Yeah.
The All England Open with Chan and Shin Sung Chan. Again, 1.72 meters, also 26 years of age. All ahead of win against Huan Yap. And today's opponents as well, they beat in straight games 15 and 17 in 46 minutes in their second group match. But they lost to Polian Rahayu, who of course couldn't make it here today because they lost to the team on the right there warming up yesterday. That was, we brought you that match on one. As we take a look at Chow Mei Kwan from the Malaysian capital. Spots off of their career high, but you sense that they could go deep in a lot of tournaments in the near future. They've been playing terrific badminton. From Malacca is Lee Meng Yan. so far. As I say, that was a terrific straight game win over Polly and Raheyu, and that really is the standout result in the group for them. Also a good win over Hu and Yap, their compatriots, 21-15 in that deciding game there. So it's been good solid display, Morton, from the young Malaysians.
It was a massive surprise yesterday in my book that they managed to win against the Puli and Rahayu. Not only that they won, but they were so convincing in two straight games, and they needed the two games to win. Had it gone to three, had Puli and Rahayu just won one game, they would have been in the semi-final today. So, big surprise.
Yeah, can they live up to the way that we've been bigging them up, the team in red and black?
It's a tall order.
It is.
They are up against a very solid Korean pair. And what we also saw in the group stage, that the Malaysians, they lost in two straight games. It's a tall order today, but can they find some of the form of yesterday? That would be fine. And in the picture here, we've got the coach from Malaysia, which is Chan Jongming. He himself a very, very good doubles player and mixed doubles player in the past.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Ri So-hee and Tin Song-shan, Polia. And on my left, Chong Mei Kuan and Lee Ming-yen, Malaysia. Ri So-hee to serve to Chong Mei Kuan. Love all. Play.
Hey!
Cross block from Shin.
Two love.
Spacious awareness from Ri So-hee. In my book, she's possibly the stronger of the two Korean players. She's serving really well, attacking. Her workload on court is immense. It's really big. She's working back and forth, attacking, and many times working her way around her partner, Shin. Shin is really struggling on her serve, which is one of the issues in the doubles combination from Korea. But a good start from the two Koreans, three love up. There's just one of the really strong areas from Shin Chongjian. Interception at the net, and look at how she's able to take off the pace on this shot. And even for a fairly quick player like Chow Mei Kwan, she was not able to get to it, and that shows it was a good quality shot.
Calm from Chow Mei Kwan. Very alert. She's electric normally, isn't she?
Four.
She's real dynamo of energy.
She's quick, she's sharp. Her strongest point, definitely her defence. When it comes to her attack, she had a shoulder injury, I think it's about 3-4 years ago. And that injury really have taken off a lot of pace and power from her smash and her attack, and is more or less purely relying on her defence now. So if I was the Korean combination, I would add on a lot of pressure in terms of attacking Lee Meng-yen. Not that her defence is poor, but Chan Wei-kwan's defence is even better. Patiently, Chan Wei-kwan is just keeping the initiative, holding on to the attack without power smashing at all. Just keeping the shots low. Yeah, that's well played by Lee Meng-yen. Wonderful defense. That's really good defense from the two Koreans. It was almost working out for Chan Wei-kwan on that defensive shot. She's quite creative when it comes to her defensive shots. And she was very close on that one. I think that would have passed Lee So-hee at the front.
Yeah, we saw that yesterday.
I was wrong. It was Shin at the front, but it was close. Look at that one. I think that could have been a winner. I think it's very important for the two Malaysians that they share the workload from the back, because otherwise it would be too easy to pin Meng-yen at the back of the court, and she would then have to do all the work. So I think it's extremely important that the two Malaysians are sharing that workload on the full court. And here, look at that. Very, again, adventurous from Mei-kwan. Unfortunately for her, it's not working out in the last kill, but try to have a look at the defensive shot first. This one here. That's unfortunate.
Yeah, it's almost the perfect turnaround, wasn't it? She was electric, wouldn't we? Because they are just vault-like.
They're very good. And they get lots and lots of shots back, even the most impossible ones. As we can see, it's a big problem already for the two Malaysian players that they can't score their points. They can't get through the defence of the two Koreans.
7-1.
Ending up in a little bit of a panic shot here from Meng-yen. The cross smash, it was, I think the idea was good, but the execution was quite poor. Fair bit out of court.
Of course, when you can't score, you just overpress.
You do.
It's the dilemma that the Malaysians might fall into. They've got to stay calm.
You go closer and closer to the lines, to the net court and so on. And you're ending up making mistakes. Like what we just saw here. Perhaps the Malaysians sense that the Korean pair is physically stronger than them. And then, of course, having this fantastic defence is adding on a lot of pressure on the two Malaysian players. Trying to find the gaps.
And
as you said, Paul, I think you're very right. Work patiently.
Oh, it's handed. Well, that'll give a little encouragement to Chow and Lee, because these two have bolted out of the gates really quickly. Bit of strapping on that left calf of Shin.
Yeah, I saw that yesterday.
Oh,
to overtake there by Mei Kwan. Because as we can see, Li Mengyan was kind of getting stuck at the back, chased from side to side, not being able to really put any pressure on the two Koreans. And we saw that Chow Mei Kwan was coming back, doing that rotational skills and sort of relieving and taking over on the workload as well. Unfortunately for her, the shot was not good enough and they got penalised on it, but the whole idea is good.
Ten, three.
11-3 interval. Well, Koreans are off to a flyer. Make no mistake, 9 minutes have elapsed, that's all. And they are 11-3 to the good as we head to the mid-game interval. Crushing it at the moment.
Koreans are sticking to 12-3. Very simple game plan. They just play it, they don't attack, they just pin the two Malaysians to the back of the court. If I were the two Malaysians, I would actually start trying to tease and tempt the Koreans to start attacking them, because it's only in the counter-attacking situations the two Malaysians can surprise the two Koreans and really set up good opportunities. So perhaps a few more lifts, a few more clears, perhaps slightly short, and then tempt the two Koreans to attack and then counter-attack that situation. To that smash from Shin Chan, and made it very hard for Mei Kwan to play a proper good shot on it. Good play by Shin. Yes, an amazing run of points for the two Koreans. But that was not bad for Lee So
Lee.
The idea was fantastic.
Just the competitive steel of Lee So-hee, doesn't it? When she misses one in such a commanding score lead, she's still so disappointed.
Service over.
Well, again, complimenting heavy smashes with nice blocks. It's all working swimmingly for Lee and Shin at the moment. They've been masterful at keeping the two Malaysians at arm's length.
Thank you. 6-14.
From the Malaysian point of view, that was a better rally because it was much more balanced in terms of attack and defence on both sides. And it's, as I say, it's tempting Shin in this instance to try to intercept, and the mistake is made. Of course, as you can see, she was very unlucky not to get it over. But nevertheless, I think that's the way forward for the Malaysians. They have to get the Korean pair out of their shell.
Look like they're playing well within themselves, the Koreans, right now. There's a challenge here. Well, is it spurned out of desperation? Lee Soo-hee looked pretty committed and happy where it landed, but we'll see. Towels sweeping across faces vigorously during the momentary break, and it was indeed long, so challenge unsuccessful.
Challenge unsuccessful, no challenge remaining. Service over.
The idea, she's normally very keen around just the radar was off momentarily then on this long, excellent point to watch.
There was a good change of pace from Lee Soo-hee from the back of the court, really surprising Mei Kwan, and played a poor quality shot. Shin should have put it away, but she didn't, and she saw the facial expressions of the two Koreans. They knew that was a good opportunity.
Yeah, she's quite demonstrative, isn't she? Shin Seung-kyo. Well, I tell you what, many more like that, she'll be stripping of that confidence, won't she?
Well, once again, the tactic of playing a little bit more defensive from the two Malaysians is definitely working out. Saw a good, nice drive here from Mei Kwan. She's very comfortable in her defence. Yeah, that's good pressure from Lee Soo-hee. Nice pressure.
Service over. 16.
Also trying to notice that it's Mei Kwan that's normally taking all the block shots and drop shots. She's the one that's moving forwards, and she's very quick on her feet and cover the front court for the two Malaysians.
And seemingly she seems to be getting a lot of traffic coming her way on a regular basis.
Play.
From Lee Soo-hee. Great call. Alerted partner, leave it.
set the tempo very early in this one, and keeping the pressure on. Kind of, it's a nice slice of grip we've got these Malaysians under right now. Placement of the smash on the forehand side to Shin Chong Chan.
9-17, Shin Chong.
Once again, the right hip is always a good placement. Look at this, yeah, perfect placement.
Sunshine.
Committed towards her backhand defense. They found it hard to score this end, haven't they, these two? It's been a real uphill struggle.
Yes,
the solidity of these two. I mean, Lee saw here, I can barely remember her making an unforced error.
No, she is solid. Very solid.
The perils of a net player, isn't it? You know, you've got to be sort of upping that risk profile, looking for it, and on occasions you're playing low percentage shots, but there we are. It was proactive and it only just missed. So since the mid-game interval, the Malaysians are actually 9-6 up, which is showing a big change of momentum in this match. A really good start from the Koreans at 11-3, and then the Malaysians are working their way back into this. Good play by them, so that is nice.
Service over,
18-12. Semi-final showing from Lee Sohee. She's been stand-up.
Oh. Yeah. Good eye, well left.
Service over. 13-18.
Good smash again from Lee Sohee.
Service over. 19-13. Service over. 14-19.
Comeback from the two Malaysians in the second part of this opening game. Of course, six game points they cannot really recover from, but I still think they've done well in the latter part of this opening game. Yeah, that's a perfect, that's a really good drive from Shin. Wonderful.
First game won by Lee.
Well, when she comes to the party as well,
Song-shan,
it's something to behold. 21-14, the Koreans take the opening game after 23 minutes of action.
Okay.
드라이버
20 seconds.
Well, when the Malaysians were 3-11 down at the turn, I thought that they might become a speck in the rearview mirror. Such was the start of the Korean assault. They really came out of the block so fast, and then a sort of spirited fight back towards the back end of that opening game. So now, with the speedier end, can they start to put a little bit more zing on their attacks? Let's find out. Must win game for the Malaysians in game two here. Koreans are game to the good.
Second game. Look on. Play.
Shame, because you kind of sense already a shift in the dynamics, the way they feel. The Malaysians are smiling and they're enjoying the change of ends instantly, aren't they, Morten? Their intensity is ratcheted up.
I think it's a much, much better start to the second game than the first game, even though it's just one rally. But as you say, it was a very spirited one. Lots of different angles to be played, and I really did enjoy it. But I think Lee and Shin, they are looking good. Really well played by Shin. Taking the chance going flat cross court, but Meng Yan was not aware and did not cover that shot. A little bit risky from the Korean, but it worked out.
Thank you.
that'll do nicely. Plenty of zing on that.
Two on. Again.
We saw an example of Shin Chung Chan's defense not as strong as Lee So Hee, I think.
Three!
But hitting a really good length this time again.
Three,
from
two.
Shin Chung Chan.
About playing it, didn't she, Shin, for a while, and then sort of backed herself. The original decision was right. It did spill over the back line.
Just taking over as the head coach of women's doubles in Malaysia.
Okay.
Taking over from that was Nurasak. One KT.
Hey! So my core challenge is called out.
It looks like a waste of talent challenge to me. Maybe they just need to break it up a bit. More tactical challenge, because it looks like the Koreans are zooming.
Challenge unsuccessful, one challenge remaining. 6-2. Play.
Malaysians can't afford that. 7-2 down now. Should have been 3-6.
Sense over pressing in the last two. A couple of unforced errors from nowhere. They've got to tidy up.
Service over. 3-8.
Well, if you live in the front court, you've got to accept that kind of responsibility.
Confusion there between the two Koreans, but Lee So Hee did the right thing. Move away and let the front player, Shin Chung Chan, come back.
She's
the one that
nine,
can see.
Four.
Shin Chung Chan do not have eyes in the back. Don't know where partner is standing. Good pressure. Well placed that smash.
Service four call too high. Service over.
Li Mengyan was
five,
kind of laughing
nine.
After that, because she got back for the flick serve nicely. Hammered back a lovely high. Clear, and with it broke a string.
Support.
Yeah.
Hey!
Prettier the scoreline from the Malaysians' perspective than it was in game one, where they went to the turn 11-3 down. Now it's 11-6, so looking a little brighter in the future.
But still a lot under pressure. Yeah. 5 points adrift is a lot, having lost the first game.
Yeah. 자, 화이팅 화이팅. 아, 힘내고 저희도 조차 계속 두고 두다. 저 재밌으면 좀
20 seconds.
남부에 태송 타지. 두 이대에 쇼거라.
Well, they're up against a very spirited resistance today, aren't they? The Koreans look so purposeful in their demeanour. There's been, they really have played some
11,
very solid
battles.
And then for the Malaysians, it's a blue wall.
Play.
Solid in every department. This lift just going wide at the sideline. It's now or never for the Malaysians. Got to win the next two or three points. Very solid day in the office from Lee and Shin. She got out of that one. Mei-Kwan, she was quite lucky.
Really well, didn't she? Yeah, that was absolutely stunning, that cross net.
But the Koreans forgot to follow up at the net when they caught Mei-Kwan at the back on the backhand side, and they had that opportunity earlier in the rally, and they should have closed it down. But even they can slip up now and again.
Some Chinese.
It's an instant challenge.
Shin Song-chan, challenge for in.
I think she knows it's in.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. And 14. Play.
Good place then. Again, one of the rare mistakes from Lee Sohee. Considering how many shots in every single rally she's playing, Lee Sohee, there's very few mistakes she's making.
Yeah, she's been incredibly solid. With the smash, hasn't she? Meng Yan. Decent little flurry of activity from these two. Koreans stopping the run of points at 15, 4 for the Malaysians. 10.
Right into the feet of her opponent. Tricky shot to control. Well played by Meng Yan.
Number fours just showing their class today, aren't they?
Slightly reversed, controlling it nicely down the line from Lee Sohee.
Yep.
That's the beauty. And then look at the follow up, just in case.
10 world ranking spots between them. It seemed like a gulf today, these two seemingly winning points at will. They've been just super solid, even in the long rallies. Only offering crumbs 16, from their table 11. To the Malaysians, who fought tooth and nail, but not a lot to show. 5-point cushion and a game to the good now, setting sail for the title decider.
Oh, that's a good interception. Very good interception.
17, well,
especially
11.
Given that she doesn't spend a lot of time in the front court, really.
Yeah.
That was really very special,
yeah,
wasn't
third
it?
Third shot. Clever.
like time is running out for Chow Mei Kwan, Li Meng Yan. Two or three times in that rally, the partner to the other one in the Korean team was saying, leave it, leave it. But all three times, chose to play the shot.
We thought they turned it round.
Yes.
Touches it over the back line.
19,
what a shame.
12.
And you do sense that was a really defining moment.
Play.
And that's a nice spinning net shot from
20,
Shin Chongchan.
Match point 12.
Setting up at match point 8 in total for the Koreans. But look at this one, that's perfection. Really well played.
Three match points have been saved, encouragingly, by the Malaysians. So there it is. The Koreans, with an excellent performance, easing into tomorrow's
match
title.
Lee So-hee and Shin Song-shan.
49 minutes they needed,
14,
coming through
21,
in a straight
15.
Game affair. 21-15, 21-14. They had all the answers today, the team in blue. Very solid showing from them. Lee Sohee in particular was just absolutely incredibly solid, working so hard throughout, as was Shin, of course. But a valiant effort from the Malaysians, but the hour belonging to Lee Sohee and Shin Seung Chan of Korea. They head through to tomorrow's final. Very purposeful, wasn't it? First winners on semi-finals day. This is what we'll be bringing you next. Kitty Harikun and Prochongjai against more Korean women's doubles players Kim So-young and Kong Hee-young. Don't go too far. That's what they're playing for.